Hey guys, today we're going to make a magnetic drain plug. And I've got to make around 24 of these things. And I've been wanting to add some to these engines I've been building. But you know, when I looked online, I found like these really nice ones. So like anywhere from $7 to 20 some dollars each. And since I'm going to have about 24, I'm going to need about 24 of them. I decided, well, maybe I'm just going to make my own. So, last week, when Andy and Jerred were working on that mini bike frame, taking the engine off, Jerred showed me a trick. He bought a bunch of these little neodymium magnets, and he put some JB Weld on the end of his extension there, and that holds the bolts and stuff in place. And I thought, and it also works as a magnetic retrieval tool. So, you know, I ordered me some of those things. And now you can get this 50-pack here off the jungle site. And I think it's around $5 or $6 for 50 of them. And these are the, these are the 8mm by 3mm size neodymium magnets. And I'll put a link down below if you guys want to pick up some. But, yeah, I wanted to make me up some of those magnetic extensions. Also, because I liked that, what he was doing with it. And, but you know, it's got me to thinking, hey, you know, I could probably JB Weld me some, these neodymium magnets on the end of those stock drain plugs and make my own, you know, so, that's what we're going to do today. The idea of a magnetic drain plug is a good one, especially on these small engines. You know, they don't have an oil pump. And it's kind of splash lubricated. So if you get a lot of metal parts down in there, the magnet will catch all those small shavings and stuff that are metallic, you know, and magnetic. It won't catch any aluminum shavings, but the small bits of steel that really does damage to your crank and stuff, it'll catch those. So what I've done here, now I'm going to start off with a couple here. And I have cleaned these up off camera. I didn't expect you guys would want to watch me clean drain plugs with the carb cleaner. So I did that off camera, and I just used the cheap carb cleaner I pick up at Wally World or any discount store. And I also took a little sandpaper, and I sanded just a little bit on the drain plug. Now what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to squeeze out a little two-part epoxy here, and this is the, you know, they call it a cold weld compound, whatever. It's just epoxy, and you get a part A and a part B. You mix them out equal parts, and I'm using JB here, so you know I'm not sponsored by those guys or anything, but you know that's what I normally use because it, you know, you stir it up and it stinks. Usually the two-part epoxy, if it stinks when you stir it up, okay, that means it's pretty good stuff, and it'll handle the gas and oil pretty well. And this stuff is good. I've actually patched busted aluminum blocks with it and everything else. So I'm a firm believer in JB. So once you mix it up good, you know, you'll turn black and white into gray. And I'm just going to start off here. I don't know exactly how much to add. I guess I'll just put a generous amount on here. And then if it, when the magnet goes on there, if it squishes out, I'll just wipe off the excess. So that's fine. These things here, man, you got to watch these. These things are powerful. And I mean powerful. That little small magnet there will pinch your finger. They're really, I mean, it's unbelievable how strong they are. And, you know, I'm not certain if a man, if you figured out north and south on them, I believe you could probably place them on the inside of a flywheel and they'd probably operate a charging coil. But now, I'm going to start off here with these and just get these two done. I think I've made up too much JB Weld. I'm probably going to have to... I wanted to do enough to do a couple of plugs and do my extension here, but looks like I'm going to have to do quite a few more. And all I'm doing here, guys, I'm just wiping off any excess because I don't want that JB Weld drying on the threads. That would be bad. No problem. Just wipe off the excess, get it out of the threads, and then let her sit up. And I did also hit the end of this extension with a little sandpaper, and I think it was 220 or 240 grit, something like that. Just to put a little few scuffs on it. Not going to remove any finish or anything. And I didn't sand these little neodymium magnets at all. Once they stick on there, man, that's holding a lot of pressure down. It's like you've got them in a clamp or a vise. That thing, they're really tight on there. So I believe, I'm going to give this JB Weld an overnight dry. I think about 24 hours, I think it's ready to go. And I had quite a few extra. So it took me, I think I made 8 drain plugs. And I still got a bunch of mags left. And, I had to have some of these. They come with a 50-pack, $5 or $6, and you can't beat it. And I ended up today, eight drain plugs, and, we got 6 extensions set up with magnets on the end. So that's a good deal, and that's the way to go. And that's all I got for you today, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. We'll see you next time.